Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review. Today it's going to be another fixed blade review. And in front of the camera here is now the Kissler Supreme Trident in the D2 steel variety. And first, as always, we're going to cover the specs of the knife. So we have an overall length of 11 and a quarter inches or 28.3 centimeters, with a blade length of 6 inches or 15 centimeters, and a handle length of 5 1/4 inches or 13.3 centimeters, and a blade thickness of 4.7 millimeters. So a very stout and sturdy blade thickness right there. And the Kissler Supreme Trident weighs, without the sheath, 174 grams or 9.5 ounces, and together with the nylon sheath, it weighs 464 grams or 16.2 ounces. So you are going to carry a little bit of weight, of course, but you get a very sturdy and well-built knife with a very good sheath to carry it in for that weight. And I think in this category of knife, the overall weight is pretty nice, especially considering the blade thickness and the overall construction. Now let's take a look at the Trident from Kissler Supreme, how it looks new out of the box. Here we have your big Kissler Supreme box with all your information on this sticker here. And let's see how it comes. So if you open it up, there you have your knife and your warranty card. So let's take the packaging out of the way and take a look at the Trident by Kissler Supreme. So you can see you have a very nice MOLLE compatible sheath with a plastic insert, and here you have your very generous belt loops and everything like that. But we're going to take a closer look at the sheath later on, and then you can take a look at the Trident itself. It even comes with this lanyard right here, so you have a little bit of paracord that goes with your knife. And here you can take a look at the blade of the Kissler Supreme Trident. So very stabby, very fighting knife like blade. Is your swedge at the top and your nice black coating. We're gonna see how this holds up in my testing. And here you can see the name Trident and that it is indeed D2 steel, and the handle and your finger guards. So this is how it looks new out of the box. And now we're gonna take a look at the sharpness out of the box and see how it cuts with its factory edge. I'm always impressed when these large and thicker knives are very sharp out of the box and cut the paper cleanly. And that seems to be the case here. So, quite impressive sharpness, especially for D2. D2 is a little bit harder to sharpen than some other steels. But you can see here, it slices pretty well, and we're gonna see how it performs after my testing in a second. Now let's take a look at the blade of the Kissler Supreme Trident. You can see here we have a characteristic swedge on the top of this drop point style blade. You have a main hollow grind and a flat right here with your Kissler Supreme logo on it. You also have dual guards and of course a full tang construction. And the whole blade is coated in a black titanium coating, which has held up pretty nicely in my testing. You can see here on the flats are a couple of scuffs right here from the betoning, but other than that, it has held up pretty nicely. As far as I'm concerned, I'm pretty happy with the performance of the coating. You also have a 9-degree spine, and you can see here these are the marks from the ferrorod striking that I have done with it. And it strikes ferrorods very, very nicely, despite the fact that the spine here is coated. It sparks very nicely with a ferro rod right here. So this is also a quite cool feature of the Killer Supreme Trident. And this version that I have here, as I said before, is the D2 steel model. As you can see here on the other side of the blade, you have the name of the model, the Trident, and that it is D2 steel. And there is also an OS 8 version available of the Trident, which is going to be a little bit less expensive. And of course, the OS 8 steel is a little bit more rust resistant, but wouldn't hold its edge for as long as D2 would. And because of that, it is easier to resharpen than D2. But I think D2 is a very nice choice for this style of knife, because it's a very tough steel, especially for a stainless or a semi-stainless steel. D2 has a very high toughness, in my opinion. But it is not quite stainless, in contrast to the OS 8, because it has about 12% of chromium, so almost, but not quite. And another nice feature of the D2 is, of course, that it can be hardened to a very high hardness, usually in the 60s. The one that Killer Supreme uses is hardened between 60 and 63, so pretty hard D2 that they use here. So with that hardness, you of course get a very good edge holding capability. One drawback of the D2 steel is, of course, that it cannot take a very fine edge like you would get on a carbon steel or a Sandvik steel, for that matter. So there is a saying about D2 that it takes a lousy edge and holds it forever, which is quite true. I wouldn't say lousy for the edge. You still are able to get a good, usable and sharp edge out of it. So lousy is maybe not the best term, but in essence, I think the statement is true. So overall, I would recommend you getting the D2 version over the OS 8 one, just for the edge holding and the toughness of the D2 steel, especially if you get the coated version. Then you have the best of both worlds. You have a good rust resistance because of the coating and all the benefits of the D2 steel as well. So very nice steel choice on the Killer Supreme Trident, in my opinion. Now let's take a look at the 5 1/4 inch long handle of the Killer Supreme Trident. So you have here Kraton handles over an ABS base, which is a stronger polymer. So very strong overall construction. The handles are attached to the scales with these Torx screws, so you can take the knife apart to build a spear or do anything else with it. And the handles overall feel very grippy and very nice in hand. You have no hot spots whatsoever. Another nice feature is this double finger guard, so you are not going forward on the blade in a stabbing motion. You are very secure here on the handle. You also have a lot of real estate here on this handle, so if you have large hands, it should be absolutely no problem to get a nice grip here on the Killer Trident. It is also very comfortable in different grips because it's quite a straight handle. Another nice thing is that it has a very hand-filling overall design. You can see here that the Killer Trident is quite a thick handle, and of course the full tang construction adds to the overall strength and sturdiness of the design. And you can see here the fit and finish on the scales as well. It's pretty nice. Here you can see there are only a couple of areas where it is not perfect, but there are absolutely no hot spots here on the handle of the Killer Trident. Also, the Kraton is an extremely grippy material. It feels a little bit rubbery to the touch and gives you a very nice feel for it, and makes this knife very nicely and easily maneuverable. So I'm really a fan of the handles. I like them a lot more than I would have thought. There are also versions available with only one finger guard. I think then it is called the Alpha and not the Trident. So there are a lot of options for this style of fixed blade from Killer Supreme, but I personally really like here the Kraton handles. Here you can see that you also have a lanyard hole on the Trident. And actually the lanyard that is attached on the knife right now is a lanyard that comes with the knife. So there's a pretty nice touch from Killer Supreme that they actually provide you with a lanyard and a little bit of cordage. If you don't have a lanyard attached, you can use this area here as a pommel, because the tang protrudes all the way through the handle to the end here. And you can hammer or do stuff like that with the end of your blade. So there's also a nice additional use of the full tang construction that they have used in the Trident design. So now let's take a look at the sharpness after my testing. So I did a lot of stuff with this blade. I did food prep, some kindling prep, also some batoning. So I really put this knife through its paces, and now we're going to see how it held up. One thing that I noticed after I got home from my last outing was a little chip, because I probably hit a rock right there. You can see it maybe right about here, because I hit a rock when I was batoning. Other than that, the edge looks pretty nice. And now let's see how well it cuts paper. So seems to be still quite nicely. So it is able to cut paper after all this hard use. Of course, not as sharp as before, but that was expected. So I'm actually quite happy with that result, especially for the type of use that this knife has endured. And I was also quite impressed with how well it performed in this, in these more survivalist tasks, because let's face it, it's a tactical design for a soldier blade or something like that. And it did also pretty well in all these camp tasks, which was quite surprising to me. Now let's take a look at the Moly compatible nylon sheath that comes with the Kistler Supreme Trident right here. So you have a Moly compatibility on the front of the sheath right here, and also on the back. You also get a piece of cordage with it, so you can attach it to your leg right here. And you have two belt attachment options. So you have your standard belt loop, where you just put your belt through it like this. And you also have these nice quick detachment belt loops, where they are attached with a snap and also some Velcro. So you have a very, very secure snap on right here, pretty well designed in my opinion. And on the Tactical Echelon series of knives, as you can see here on this protruding FRN part out of the nylon sheath, you get this protruding part, which is a special locking system for these kinds of sheath, which allow you to carry it without the top snap attached and still have a very, very secure fit and no rattling here in the sheath. So very nice addition, I think, is this protruding FRN part, which also protrudes down, of course, so you don't cut your nylon or anything like that. You also can actually detach the top snap, which is attached by Velcro to this little loop here, so you can just remove that altogether and just carry it with this Tactical Echelon system. And I'm now going to demonstrate to you how you use this special feature. So you just put your thumb right here and press it up a little bit, and then you take out your knife. So pretty easy to get a hang of. You just have to know how to use it. And if you put it in, you see it snaps in quite securely. It's a very, very nice fitted sheath. The blade is in there quite snugly. Now let's come to the size comparisons. First, I have for you a folding knife from Kistler Supreme, which has a very, very similar overall blade shape. And also the handle is pretty similar in the overall design. And I think these two would make a pretty cool team for some outdoor activity, or even as a tactical folder and a tactical fixed blade. Both of them are pretty well built, and I really think the similarities in the blade shape are quite striking. So maybe this is actually the same designer that designs these two knives at Kistler. So that is a little bit of an off-the-cuff comparison, but really cool knife here, the Kistler Supreme Biker Z. Now let's get to the fixed blade comparison I have for you. First off, I have the Radops Black Tiger, which is a smaller, a little bit more all-around type of knife. And you can see it's quite a bit smaller. Also a very nice knife with a very, very good steel choice overall. Another comparison that I would put more in a tactical role would be here the Bad Blood Rotorhead, which has a very, very nice a G10 contour, G10 handle, and a Wicked Persian style blade, as you can see here. But it has the inferior steel, the ATR 14 MOV, I believe. Here you can see these two are also a little bit similar in the overall size. But of course, the Killer Supreme is a good bit longer, especially in the blade. So that was the Bad Blood Rotorhead fixed blade. And a last comparison that I have for you would be the Southern Grind Jackal, which has a carbon steel blade and a very, very nice and unique FDE coating on there, and an extremely ergonomic handle, even though it is not the thickest handle. Maybe I can show you here the thickness comparison. You can see here that the Killer Supreme's Kraton handle is much more hand-filling than the thin G10 handles of the Jackal. But despite that fact, it is an extremely ergonomic knife with a nice jimped ramp right here. So these two are pretty nice knives. I would also think that the Jackal is more of an all-rounder, like the MK1 Black Tiger, and a little bit more all-round capable than the Killer Supreme Trident, which is geared more to the tactical side of things, in my opinion. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about the Killer Supreme Trident. So if you want to get yourself a Trident, you are going to pay around $125 to $165, depending on steel choice and finish, and also depending on which retailer you use. You're going to find a link to my recommended retailer in the description box as always, and also a link to the Killer Supreme website where you can check out the specs and stuff like that again. And I think for that amount of money, you get a really nice tactical or fighting knife with a very nice reach of a 6-inch blade, with a very generous 5 1/4-inch handle, with very good Kraton handles, which are very grippy and feel nice and secure in hand, and the nice double finger guards, which prevent you from going forward onto the blade in a stabbing motion, and also a very aggressive blade shape with the swedge at the top. But in my experience, it also functioned very well as a camp or medium-sized survival knife, despite this blade shape, because of the thickness and the overall nice handle design. And of course, you also get a very nice sheath with it. The sheath is very, very impressive, with this special locking method and all the different attachment methods you get with the cordage and the two belt loops and everything like that. It is really one of the best nylon sheath that I have seen so far. Also, the steel is a very big plus of the Killer Supreme Trident. I really like the D2, especially the one that they use here with a very nice hardness between 60 and 63 Rockwell, which holds an edge pretty nicely, and is also quite tough steel paired with the very thick blade stock of 4.7 millimeters. So pair that up with a nice quality construction out of Russia, with a very nice fit and finish and overall craftsmanship, and you have a very nice knife for your money that will certainly serve you very well. I am very happy with my Killer Supreme Trident, and this was my review. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions about the Killer Supreme Trident or anything else I have talked about in the review, please leave a comment and I will try to answer you as soon as possible. If you want to see more of these gun, knife and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.